Tax season is here, and if you think you're going to be getting a refund, there's some important information you need to know to make sure your money doesn't end up in the wrong hands. Sean Ibarra has more in tonight's Action Line Consumer Alert.
What's worse than doing your taxes? How about finding out someone already submitted a return in your name and stole your refund?
Tax-related identity theft occurs when someone uses a stolen Social Security number to claim a refund and filing a fraudulent tax return.
The IRS says thieves will often request a refund electronically, which can easily be deposited into an account. The Better Business Bureau says tax-related identity theft often happens when people get careless safeguarding their personal information.
We've had instances of people posting things online. You know, we're all familiar with someone being proud of their son or daughter, and they post their W-2 online.
Last year, the IRS opened more than 1,000 tax identity theft investigations and prosecuted over 700 people nationwide.
You know, last year, unfortunately, we had a consumer who had, you know, this was later in the tax season, had gone to file his return, and he was notified that it was already sent in.
There are some things you can do to help spot or prevent yourself from becoming a victim. First, it's a good idea to file your taxes early, since many schemers try and get a head start on taxpayers. Second, safeguard your Social Security number.
When you're dealing with someone's identity, it's very dangerous, because not only then is it tax related, but it's related to basically your whole life.
And if you file by paper, make sure you drop your return in a secure mailbox. If you file online, make sure it's from a secure network. If you have questions or think you're a victim of tax-related identity theft, visit our website for a list of resources. And if you have a consumer concern, or if you're interested in becoming an Action Line volunteer, call 591-0222 weekdays from 11 a.m. to 1 p.m. or send an email to actionline@khon2.com. Sean Ibarra, KHON2 News.